So is the Trump agenda of tax cuts and health care reform at risk of being derailed? Joining us now, Republican strategist Chris Neiweem and Capitalist Pig hedge fund manager Jonathan Hoenig. Thank you both for joining us.
Good to be with you.
Thank you.
Jonathan, let's start with you. We're talking about the agenda. You think it's derailed. What do you think at this point? Because now we're in this crisis mode, Washington.
Well, keep in mind, so much of what was on the president's agenda was actually already supposed to be accomplished. And now with this news about the Comey memo and this downdraft in the stock market, 100-plus points, you really have to wonder, is that agenda off track? Whether it's the tax cuts, whether it's the health care reform, the regulatory reform, this is now political uncertainty. And, you know, it's a lot easier to figure out, I don't know, how many Huggies Walmart is going to sell as against what's going to happen in Washington, D.C. So the Democrats, and I do believe they have a lot to hold on to here, if they keep pursuing this path, you could see not just Trump's agenda, but the market and the economy fall off track as well.
You can obviously make the point that this morning investors are nervous, but the stock market either at or near an all-time high, depending on what you look at, shows that there is this underlying belief that Donald Trump will fulfill tax cuts and health care reform. So Chris, I ask you, is his base still supporting him? Are we still optimistic that his agenda will go through?
I think time is of the essence. I think his base is still with him, but I think he needs to get things done. One thing he's succeeded at politically is sort of hammering people, sometimes kind of deflecting and pointing fingers, but as president, it's going to rest on him as agenda. So I think he should focus on tax reform and trying to get support in the Senate, and I think that this distraction is limiting the clock. But time is of the essence. Those midterm elections, there are going to be consequences if they can't get those victories, and I think they need to focus on the clock here. Time is ticking.
Jonathan, let me ask you about the tax cuts. If everything gets pushed back, which right now it feels a little pressured at the moment, what about these tax cuts? Do they come? When?
Well, we would hope they would have come already, and so much of the rally we've seen since November, keep in mind the stock market was quite soft since November. We saw this explosive rally, the Trump trade as they called it, and as you said, the bull market, in my estimation, is still intact. Tax cuts or no tax cuts, we've got over 2-to-1 new highs yesterday on the New York Stock Exchange. The fear is, of course, moving forward, and you mentioned some of the retail earnings today. That's been a particular soft spot, so if we continue to see stocks like Target, stocks like JCPenney, stocks like Macy's fall, that could spell trouble for the consumer, for the Trump trade, and for the economy writ large.
Let me ask you, Chris, how does the White House contain these leaks, perhaps the source of the leaks, and how do they move forward from all these distractions that continue to flare up, particularly this week?
Well, I have to admit, sometimes I think the White House is starting happy hour a little bit early. I mean, they've got to get the chain of information under control, and I think that rests with the president. I mean, when they're out of sync and they're running around like that, I mean, it just gives the media that ammunition. So I think they need to get a communication strategy that's in sync, and we'll have to see if there's anything to this memo and what comes out, because, again, anonymous person, no memo, you know, again, it's the chain of information is not really there yet, but they have got to get their communications team on track so they're not playing defense, because time is of the essence, and they've only got so much time to get their agenda through Congress.